Welcome everybody to a new episode of Flower Circus Talks. Today, again, a very special episode. Today, we're going to go to Greece. I mean, we have been in Australia, Colombia, Ecuador, England, and now we're in Greece as well. So for that, I've got a very special friend, Dimitris Papadakis, who's a florist, floral designer. He's the owner of Flowers Papadakis in Athens. He's also the Greece Vice President at Athens Florists Association. So let's quickly invite him into the live stream and see what he has to tell.
Good afternoon. Welcome all my friends from everywhere of the world. Thank you, John, for your kind invitation to talk about floral literature, about business, and about our thought for the future. As you say, I am Dimitris Papadakis. I am a third generation flower entrepreneur. My grandfather and my father were growers of chrysanthemums, of carnations and tulips. I tried different professional paths. I studied administration and law in university in Athens. But in the end, becoming a professional flower designer, and I have a floral business, my own floral shop. I'm also a certificate teacher of floral art. I am a teacher by a certificate by the National Ministry of Labor of Greece. And I am teaching new florist theory and techniques of floral art. I teach them, I teach them theory about colors, about constructions, and of course many techniques about our business, about our work. The last 9 years I am the vice president of Greek Florist Association. The most of florists in Greek, they know me. We have worked within associations. We have organized floral competitions in Greece. For all of these competitions, I was the president of organotic committee and also at the technical committee about how competitors works, about the rules, about the plans, about the organization. And so at the last competition, we have also competitors from Russia, Olga Sarova. Yes, from Italy, Francesco Maino. From Portugal, Alla Stefanouk. And also in our judges, there are Ivan Berg. Yes, we have very, very important persons in our competitions. We hope next year to do again good competitions. And I hope to pandemic finish to go to Poland for the European competitions of Florint. Florint is a very good association for all florists. They work very, very serious. They support all florists everywhere, and it is very important for yes, of course, with Marius Valianos. Yes, of course, Marius Valianos is the president of our association, and we are working for many affairs. Of course.
There was a question for Kirsten.
Yes. welcome, Kirsten. Welcome, everybody, to our video, to our flower circus. I remember I remember you, dear John, before 2 years in Salonika. You presented new products, new techniques in floral art, and of course you gave new ideas to promote retail commerce and B2B business between us. It's very important for us. I really appreciate your efforts to give a different approach of communication between growers and traders. it is very important for all of us to communicate, and of course between markets and florists. And I want to give you my congratulations for your efforts.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. It is very important to develop new relations.
Yeah.
Between all of us. I'm very glad we keep connected also during the pandemic. I attend your flower circus every week. They are very important, and I wish you the best to continue all this effort for us.
Thank you very much for the kind words. We indeed met 2 years ago in Thessaloniki at with Dina. We did a show there, and
yes,
before the pandemic, actually, we were already talking again with Dina to do another show in Greece. But unfortunately, the pandemic struck, and luckily we have second best, and we can talk like this to each other. And it's really great to see you again, and how you. You're so enthusiastic and helping all the florists out. I mean, that's even more important than ever with a global pandemic. But I can imagine, I mean, Greece, the last couple of years, it's not only the pandemic, we had the economical crisis as well in Greece. So I think it's already for many years a tough time for the Greek florist, is it?
I think that our florist, was in very, very good condition before crisis, before 10 years.
Yeah.
Now, to doing business has become very challenging in Greece. Retail has been closed from March of 2020 after government order. Expected from the summer season, the few days in Christmas and the Valentine's Day. At this period, we have been forced to shift to a completely distance-based model,
yeah,
relying on telephone orders at our shop. We are closed. Our doors are closed. It is a very big problem for all of us. But the shift to this model, which consumers now discover for our sector by electronical media,
yeah,
and the fact that we have not ceremonies, we have not weddings, and we have a big problem with the confidence of customers. All these are a very big problem for us.
Yeah.
I hope that all this will finish as soon as possible, because we have not limits now for other time.
Yeah,
the time is finished for us. It is the second year for Greece without weddings.
Yeah,
weddings is a very big part of our business. For me, it is necessary to collaborate with our professional associations, with Commerce Chamber, with other commercial associations, to talk with government representative in the responsible ministries, and create a solid plan for the reopening of our shop.
Yeah.
Now it's the time. We're talking about this with the Minister of Commerce, with the Minister for Agriculture, for the Minister of Economical Affairs. Of course, we have to respect the sanitary measures, keeping our clients and ourselves safe. It is very important for all of us. I think that this period, we must think all about what happened, and to replan our business.
Yeah.
If you want to talk about my floral business, to explain what I mean.
Yeah.
I believe it is very important for each florist to offer to their customers fresh and quality flowers in beautiful floral design, and of course in good price.
Yeah.
But at this time, it is not only one type of customer. we have a lot of types of customers. I have a commercial approach that I talk about for a multi-customer one approach.
For me,
it is the first line of approach. It is the B2B business. What I mean, that line include floral gift for companies, for hotels. I deliver flower arrangement, vases and decoration for receptions and lobbies, for example. But I also often do designs for yachts. We have near us the port of Piraeus, and we have a lot of boats for leisure. So I do decoration to welcome special guests, special tourists, as well as decoration for conference, exhibition, presentation, congress. This is B2B line that every serious florist is a good part of our business. And I think it's a basical for us to grow up this line. The second line of business is our cooperation for the last 30 years as partner and executive member with one of the important international platform of international order, the Interflora Flerop. It is a very strong platform, very serious. We do business with Interflora Flerop the last 30 years, and not only for Interflora. We collaborate with Flora Express, with Flora Queen. It's a unique line that offer us orders from abroad.
That's great.
Yes, it needs, of course, a very special philosophy about ordering, about executing the flowers. It is not simple. It is very complicated, and I think it is a very, very, very important also for us to execute orders from abroad. Of course, the quality at this line it's very high. The customers want very high quality freshness and beautiful flowers. The third line of our activity is the wedding industry, as we say before. My flower shop, my floral business, we offer high quality service like planning, also organizing and decorating of ceremonies, receptions, photo shooting, and others. You know, I like to use garderoses from a David Austin luxury collection for weddings. It's my lovely roses, my lovely material. We offer this service in the whole country, not for Region Attica. This includes Greek island like Mykonos, like Santorini, famous islands, Kefalonia, Crete, and many others. Our network includes a very big team of professional floral designers that can offer high standard quality of services all around Greece. I hope this summer will be full of weddings. It's my wish for all Greek florists, for all florists
around the world.
Everywhere in the... we are waiting for big weddings. Because wedding is full of flowers, not only a bouquet. The tables, the venues, the candles, the tables. We consume a very big amount of flowers. The fourth line is e-business. All we're talking for e-business now. We get a lot of orders and visitors through our platform and the social media accounts in Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, Twitter, and of course, organically from Google. Google is a very good area to find customers, to find people that love flowers, and of course, to approach them like clients. For this period, I think that all florists should be informed what happens in Facebook, what happens in Instagram, what this media offer to all of us.
Yeah.
We have the need to presentation our floral products, to see all the people, the photos, our work, our design, our services, and to approach them to come with us.
It's a really easy way to reach out to the customers, because they don't have to walk past your shop. You can reach them wherever they are around you with your beautiful designs.
Yes, of course. Now we have this ability that is unique for all of us.
Yeah.
To show to the people what happened in our floral shop.
Yeah.
What do we do?
Yeah, and I mean, all the content we have, if we make a picture of a bouquet that you just made, it always looks great. I mean, so the content is always good. I mean, people love flowers. So if you show a beautiful bouquet, people will love it. And just tell them, come to my shop and you can buy it. Or I will send it to you. If your shop is open, you can get them to your shop. And otherwise, you say, call this number and we will deliver it today or tomorrow.
Yes, of course. We have the ability to show our work, to show our new products, to show our new flowers.
Yeah, I mean, it's
very useful for all of us, and I think with the photos to accompany with a positive message about what happens with flowers. Flowers have energy. Flowers give oxygen. Flowers make people feel better. I think all this is a package that we should to forward to our clients, to our people, to our friends.
Yeah, I mean, it's so important. And I see that a lot of people are also coming in or are already in. Alison is in. Hi, gentlemen. Good to see you, Dimitris. Barbara Blossom is in from Rhode Island. We've got Regina from Poland in. And Kirsten is asking actually what I also wanted to ask. We got to four different points of how you were selling. She's asking, with the hospitality industry at a halt, your first and third lines are affected. Do you think the new variety of customers can balance this a bit going into the spring and the summer? So the fourth line, will it help? Or did it grow so much that it replaces the weddings and things like that? And the B2B, of course?
I think that a new variety of customers can balance, of course, a bit into the spring-summer. We need every man, every woman, every client, every customer that come with us and buy a bouquet, an arrangement, a basket. We need to approach all people with love, I say, to come with us in our business.
Yeah,
it's very important for us to be friendly, to be positive, give hope at this period about the life, about the moments, about the future.
Yeah. Are there also, in Holland, we see a lot of younger people buying flowers. Is that also happening in Greece now, that younger people start buying flowers?
Yes, of course. Yes, of course. Young people in Greece, all people love flowers. And give flowers, give bouquets at the every moment.
Yeah,
we see new people, new girls, new boys to buy one roses for his boyfriend, for his boy girl, for his friend girl. It is common for us. At this point, I want to say that I give special prizes for students, for new girls, for new boys, to use flowers in their relations.
Yeah, that's a really good one, actually.
I want to say hi to Alison Bradley. Thank you very much. Have a nice afternoon with us, to Mrs. Alison Bradley.
No, it's. I think you're just saying it. I give a discount to students, but that's a really great way to get them in, to start them using flowers or buying flowers, and then when a relation starts, and then the girlfriend says, "You remember when you bought me flowers?" And then he will buy flowers more and more and more, because that's part of the relationship.
Yes, it is very, it's very important for all of us to be close to the youth people, yeah. And of course to support their moves about life.
Yeah.
To give the opportunity to come to buy flowers and to buy in good prices a bouquet for Mother Day, for Woman's Day. We offer special price in bouquets for this day for young people.
Okay.
I think that these young people, after 10 years, that are a good customers.
Yeah, then we can have more money.
Yes. We can say now it's the time to educate them what means flowers, to give one roses.
Yeah,
it is very important for us. It is not the only marketing tip. It is a real tip for all of us to have future clients.
We
should educate people about the flowers, the meaning of flowers. What happens if you give the flowers? It is very important for all of us, and of course for clients.
Yeah.
Also, I want to add for this the last line for me, but is very important, is our physical clients, the people that come to our flower shop, people who become our friends, the people who support us all days of the year with a friendly touch. Laughing together and crying together, talking about all the precious moments in life.
Yeah.
We know what happens in their family.
Yeah.
We live together. It's very important. All these people love us, love flowers. And we love them. We appreciate their support. And we are very thankful to have all these customers returning every time to our shop to their special moments in life with flowers.
Yeah.
And this is the total approach about what happened with the clients, every kind of clients, every kind of customers. I think that everyone, a florist, should be very, very focus what exactly want to do in his floral business.
Yeah.
What line is better for him?
Yeah. I totally agree. I mean, you have five lines, and now you see that there's an economical crisis. But also, always, some of them will perform good, and some of them will perform maybe less. But depending on the economical situation or pandemic or whatever, it will balance out.
Yes, of course. I think that it is a calm period for florists to examine all their possibilities. To look on the problems, to solve their activities that it is not useful.
Yeah.
It's a good time to restart and to value our lessons. What is the lesson that we have all florists at this period?
Yeah.
There are a lot lessons that I say very, 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 very sometimes that the real life lessons are never easy.
Yeah.
But are sometimes more valuable than the others we learn from school or universities. The real life lessons. What it means? What means? Yeah. We need to take this time to look at this experience as means to make changes and improvements to how we run our business.
Yeah.
We should always try to do our best to analyze each situation, try to avoid future problems, and be willing to adapt and make adjustments to survive and thrive through any circumstances. What exactly I mean about what we should do after all?
Yeah.
I want to note about communication. It's very effective action. I'm talking about effective, clear, and transparent communication between all of us in a floriculture industry, but between customers, between growers, between florists, all the sectors of our industry. We see how important is the real-time communication, like now. We see what happens with the update about the availability of flowers, what happened with transportation, delivery. I think that good communication make happier and more effective all of us.
Yeah.
Customers, partners, employees. Through transparency and communication, we can easily solve a lot of problems at the same moment, not after.
Yeah,
it is totally very important. Agree.
Yeah.
Yes, after communication, I think that is the trust. What is the trust? We have learned and accepted that during times like this, the most valuable is the trust that our customers, that our partners, our suppliers have in us.
Yeah.
I trust you, John, and so I am with you.
Yeah.
Alison, trust us and is welcome with us. With us.
Yeah.
I think that the culture of business based on trust, appreciation, and strong relationship with all of its stakeholders create a sustainable business and help it to flourish in the long run.
Yeah.
We should always strive to build, and maintain high levels of trust with us.
Yeah, I mean it's about the trust between all the parts of the flower business, but also the trust of your customers. I mean,
yes, of course,
they come to you with every big thing in their life, from birth, baptizing is very big in Greece. A big floral thing, weddings, the first boyfriend or girlfriend, which is giving flowers, and of course also at the end of the life. So they trust you as well with the precious moments in their life.
I want to note and say that if someone from America want to do his marriage in Greece, he need trust at first to offer you the wedding.
Yeah.
And after is a communication, effective communication, to do the best for the for this people, for this client.
Yeah.
We need all this. Also, I want to add the strategy of diversification. We see that lately, all florists are confronted with high prices of import flowers due to decreasing the production.
Yeah.
It is necessary to approach again local growers of seasonal flowers for better price. We have to keep developing new markets and new products to find new ways of doing business.
Yeah.
Advertising, new ways of advertising, new ways of promoting. It's very useful, all this. It is the time, I think, that all be very fast, not slow, to cover the space of pandemic.
Yeah.
And I don't know if you agree about this.
I agree about it, but I'm still thinking also about the high prices and things that are happening. I think as a florist, sometimes you also need to let go that you always, of course, you always need roses in your shop. Other flowers, maybe if one type of flower is very expensive, maybe you can ask your supplier what's at the moment for a better price or for a normal price. So then I think personally think two things happen. Your shop is always changing, so it's more interesting for your customers. And you can also offer them maybe a little bit better price because you're moving around a little bit to look for better prices. But if you always stick to, I need one box of roses, one box of chrysanthemum, one box of this, one box of this. First of all, your shop never changes. And second of all, your prices will be really high because you have nowhere to go.
I think that for this problem, all florists, it is need to have information what happened with the prices of products. Yeah. Our imports should be inform us what happened in the market,
yeah.
What happened with lilium, what happened with roses, what happened with arthurium, with the cymbidium, what happened. If we see that one of these products go on in his price to substitute with the other,
yeah.
We have 100, 200, 300 products available this time to buy, yeah. Not only red roses.
Yeah,
we must do changes in the way of thinking.
Yeah,
to do better florists, to be better, to have better profits.
Yeah.
For this, I want to say about this point about the financial management.
Yeah.
Before you start,
Kirsten is saying Greece must be a huge wedding or destination wedding venue. I will show some pictures later, Kirsten, because we have some beautiful pictures Dimitris sent. So I will show them a bit later.
Thank you very much. You are welcome to Greece for holidays, for business, for everything you want, for good Mediterranean food, for dance, for ouzo, for sunset in Santorini. You are welcome, everybody.
Okay. So the financial.
Can I continue?
Yeah, the financial part.
Okay. The last year showed us how important it is to have a strong cash position to help the survival of business. It is necessary to make decision and cut operation the expenses that are not profitable.
Yeah.
It's the time, it's the moment that we have not other solutions. We must have only good solutions that are profitable.
Yeah, totally.
To survive our business. After this, I talk about Zoom, Google Meet.
Yeah.
You know. It is goes the year of this. It is goes the way of digital communication with our customers and partners. I give a lot of time of my time at this period to communicate with my clients.
Yeah.
I give a lot of time to communicate with other members of associations. It is very useful for all this. The last year was also the year that everyone started using the social media platforms to post flowers, as we say before, arrangement, new products, and introduced his work. Yeah. But it is the year of e-commerce.
Yeah.
What mean e-commerce? E-commerce sales have increased up to 30% the last year. It is sure that this trend will continue in the future.
Yeah, for sure.
Yes, this is a very serious for us. What happened? E-commerce? Yes, e-commerce. It is a source of sales, commerce.
Yeah.
Of course, the other value for us at this time is education. Yesterday, I saw a very interesting demonstration by Gregor Letts in Berma Institute.
It was really
congratulations,
interesting.
Berma. It's very interesting indeed. education give us more possibilities. It is this year, this is the calm year without a lot of work, is an opportunity to learn and become better professionals. I encourage all florists to find books and start reading about floral art, about floral design, about floral strategies of sales. All these are very important, I think, and very useful. Also, we can watch a webinar about floral art, about new products, marketing, competitions, about the use of social media, about sustainability of flower shops. It is a very, very, very important. What is sustainability of flower shops?
Yeah, I mean, it's such a great era, I think. If you want to learn something, you go to YouTube and you just type the subject and you can watch hundreds of hours of what you want to learn.
Yes, so of course, of course. I think that all these are useful. Also, the commercial method for better sales.
Yeah.
We need better sales. We are traders, retail traders, but we need to sell flowers. How we sell flowers? Not in traditional method, but the new methods that allow us to have more profits.
Yeah.
I think that is the lessons that we have in our mind to be better, to be better florists, better entrepreneurs, better businessmen.
Yeah, I mean.
Okay.
totally agree, actually, on all your points. It's so important now to learn more e-commerce as well. It can be a threat because big companies start up e-commerce and trying to sell flowers, but you can join as well and just advertise in your local community so you can grow your awareness of your business in the local community so they don't have to walk past your shop. But maybe they always go left from their house. But if they go right from their house, your shop is there in 200 meters, but they have never seen it. But if you can reach them via Instagram or Facebook or YouTube or whatever, it's a new opportunity to reach out to customers. And that's a great thing. And every florist should use it.
I think that is the lesson, that is the opportunity, that is the step that we go on next years.
Yeah.
What is the business of future? What is the flower shop of future? What it means?
Yeah.
I like people that physically come to my shop, but I cannot do business only with these people.
Yeah.
The market is open. It is not closed to my neighbor, to my city. We can approach people from other countries to send flowers, bouquets to their parents, to their friends, to their daughters, of course. It is very important for all of us to have opportunities and to give them value.
Yeah, that's I think the last part you said, to give them value, that's very important. If you look around all over the world, if they're just looking for flowers, of course they have value, but if they just quickly want to have some flowers, they can go to a supermarket. But as a florist, if you can make it better, make it look nice, better quality, different shapes, and tell the story about the flowers as well, and help them with the vase or with other things, there are so many more things you can do as a florist.
I think that florists are clever people and give a unique value to their products. Of course, flowers of a supermarket are a big problem for markets, not only for us in Greece, also in Europe. The markets are big shops. They have a strong money support from banks, from capitals. We have not this availability, but I think florist, every florist is a hard worker and give to his product a unique value.
Yeah.
With a unique composition, with a unique abalage, with a special offer.
Yeah.
We have advantages, of course, against the supermarkets, but the supermarket, it is sure a big enemy for all of us.
Yeah.
We see after all this about supermarket. If you want to talk now about the Greek flower industry,
I want to talk about the florist. I mean, the supermarkets, I mean, it's there, we know it, but I think we need to create something that we need to make more value for the people. And I think in a lot of times the florist is too shy, because if I step into a florist shop, I think the florist is the specialist. If I go to a butcher, I think the butcher is the specialist, and we need to stand out more like the specialist. If you want something special, come to me, to the florist. I know what to make, what is special for you. I mean, that's I think very important as florist. Okay, stand up and say, okay, I'm the florist, I can help you, I listen to you, and I exactly know which flowers you want, what will fit for your wedding. Or I think that's really important.
If one customer come to my shop, he wants to choose several flowers, not a packet in supermarket.
Yeah.
Also, he wants a customized product to his needs. He said to me, I want a bouquet for my daughter. He said to me that I want an arrangement for my wedding. These are the advantages of florist. We can offer unique bouquet, unique arrangement. And for this point, I add this. The most of florists are very good educated.
Yeah.
They know what happened with floral art. It is not a simple bouquet. It is a bouquet with a good combination of colors. This is are very fresh. The quality is very high. The freshness is very, very good. Also, he gave from us a very, very nice product.
Yeah.
We offer to customers unique products, and we design every ceremony, every wedding, every day, new designs.
It's always a unique design for a florist.
Yes. It's the point that can do the value to our products.
Yeah.
The supermarket sells magic. They said 100, 200 bouquets, the same.
Yeah.
And I think, different, not unique, and maybe not fresh.
Yeah. I think also
this is the point that we said we should to send to our customers what is the difference between the bouquet of flower shop and the bouquet of supermarket.
Yeah.
We give guarantee. Our flower shop lasts in the vase 2 weeks. It is very important point that we should inform our clients.
Yeah.
And know exactly what means this bouquet 5 euros and this bouquet 20 euros. It is not the same.
Of course not. It's also it's helping the clients with everything, and also tell them how to put that in their vase at home. It's the whole package.
I think it is our duty to educate people, to educate customer what about happens with the flowers. Are not all the flowers the same? Are not all the cars the same? Each car has unique price.
Yeah.
Each flower has unique price. we see at the market of Holland that we have categories. We have A2, A1, Xena. Yeah. We have luxury quality. We have not luxury quality. We have 60 centimeters length. We have tall, we have high. No one flower is the same with the other.
Yeah.
So so the prices, it's not the same.
Oh yeah, it's always changing, and
yes, of course, yes, of course. Change about the quality, change about category, change about country.
Yeah.
Other time, other prices have the Kenya roses. Other prices has Portanova roses.
Yeah.
But the client maybe don't know what happens. It is our duty to explain why this rose cost €5, why this cost, this rose of supermarket cost €1.
Yeah, I mean, it's easy to explain. A Lada is also cheaper than a Mercedes. I mean,
yes, of course. It is very easy for Mercedes and Lada. It is not easy for roses.
Yeah, but
you know,
I think Mercedes is paying a lot of money in marketing to tell that they have a good brand, and that's why they're more expensive. But in florist or florist shops, we're not telling enough, I think, that there is a difference in quality. Not one rose is the same. I agree.
Every grower should be inform his clients what happened with his products.
Yeah,
the quality, the service, the new varieties, the guarantee that give to them about how much days they last.
Yeah,
I appreciate that Portanova give to us 2 weeks life in the vase.
Yeah.
It is a guarantee for me. And I pay, I know that I pay a more expensive price, but I prefer to buy Portanova.
Yeah, but I think a lot of people think maybe if I buy it a little bit cheaper, but a claim is always more expensive. And if one out of the 10 stems is not good, that makes the whole bunch already 10% more expensive. So people need to calculate as well what happens in the end. If I buy 100 roses from Portanova, I know I will sell 100 roses because there will be none broken, or I don't have problem with vase life. And if maybe another grower, 10% is not good enough to sell anymore, then you lose 10%. And you are not going to make it back.
I think that It's very important for all of us to know what exactly we buy.
Yeah.
If we buy luxury quality, if we buy Xena quality, X1 quality, or we buy A2 quality, or B2 quality. If we know what exactly we pay, we understand the difference.
Yeah.
For me, it is very useful every florist to have a approach to prices, prices. What price we have in Flora Holland?
Yeah, it's really important. And also, we talked about trust, but also trust from the company where you buy your flowers. What quality do you buy? Do they know what quality you want? Do they know maybe one grower has a problem, so it's better to take another grower this week? Things like that. It's all about trust, because as a florist, you also only have two hands and two eyes. You can't do everything. So you need to trust the import company, or the company in Holland, or maybe even the grower who is telling you, okay, maybe this week it's better to buy somebody else because I have a little bit of a problem. Or just so you know, I have a problem. You can still buy them, but this is what is going on. I think this is very important, that the communication between all the change in the whole flower industry, that can be much better than it is at the moment.
Look, in Greece, we have flowers in our shop. We have flowers in the supermarket. We have also outdoor sales in the corners of the roads sometimes. But I am sure that the quality of flowers is different.
Yeah,
it is not the same. It is not the same. If we have a client that is regularly a client of flowers, he always knows what exactly buys, and he knows exactly what is the value of the flowers of flower shop and the value of the corner of the road, the flowers. What means also what is the value of a bouquet in a supermarket? It is very important for all of us, the customers, to have information and to try to educate them what happened with our products. It is not the same. It is our duty to educate the people.
Yeah.
To offer flowers, to choose flowers, and to pay flowers. It is our duty. I think the florist is the people that have instant touch with the feelings of people.
Yeah.
So we should talk them. What about? It is the same. It is not the same. My rose lasts in vase 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Not for 1 hour. Not for 1 day. Last for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And if it is true, the client is okay.
Yeah.
Come again.
It's all trust. It's all trust.
Yes. Exactly this.
Yeah.
I say that this bouquet lasts 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Again, customer return to us and say the bouquet is already in our vase after 3 weeks.
Yeah,
it's my advantage.
Yeah, they start talking about it and they say
yes.
Yeah, some people might even say I thought 2 weeks was not possible, but now they're even 3 weeks in the vase. So that's really important to have those things. And once you have somebody telling that you have a great flower shop with great quality flowers, it's free advertisement, and it's also the best advertisement because an independent person is telling about you.
Yes, of course. Now I want to say that it is very useful if we order from Market of Holland, from our importers, to order direct from the growers.
Yep.
They cut flowers direct from us, for us. It is a very good tip to have always fresh, not stock, but very, very fresh flowers cut for us. I prefer it to order from direct from growers.
Yeah, I can imagine. And then what you see with some products, you can already see that the growers are already also packing it for the customer. So the less people touch the flowers, the better it is, and the quicker they can ship it. So that's I think something that's happening now or changing in Holland, that's really important quality wise.
The internet gave us the possibility to approach direct the markets.
Yeah.
Every good florist should have 1 hour time every day to attend, to see what happens, what is the availability of the flowers in the market today, tomorrow, yesterday, to have a total view what is the market of flowers, and approach them and choose what he wants in quality, in prices, from who grower, and what qualification has this product.
Yeah,
it is very important, and also it is very important to have a good a good communication between traders and florists. Yeah. Florist is not the last piece of the chain, is the first.
Yeah. It's actually what we do during the Flower Circus shows as well. We're not only sending information, but we're trying to get information from the florist as well. So we get it connected.
Yes.
People understand each other better, because that's the most important thing. The florists are the eyes and the ears of the whole chain. So up till the breeders, what do they see? Which varieties or which colors are working better? All those trends, that's the florist who notices them first, or sometimes even makes the trends.
The florists are the ears of the growers.
Yeah.
If the trader cannot listen what I say, he lose.
Yeah.
It is a real fact, this.
Yeah. I totally agree.
I think that is a very, very good time to have better relations with all stakeholders of floristry.
Yeah.
To communicate, to change our ideas, to talk about our needs, about our problems.
Yeah.
It is the exactly time that this create result, positive result for all of us in floristry. And also it is the time to invite again all the clients near us. The flower is a very good help to them to feel better.
Yeah, and that's proven in so many studies. So
yes, dear John, many times I give without money flowers, offer flowers to my clients, because I need to communicate with them. I need to see them to smile.
Yeah.
I need them to say me thank you.
I'm totally agreeing. Alison was saying, I'm nodding all the time. I'm doing the same, Alison. Hopefully you're not getting sick from my head going up and down all the time. You are so right. I mean, funny thing, we had during a show in England, we had a lily grower who was joining us, and he was cutting his lilies as long as possible. So there were only two layers on a trolley. And we started talking, and then the wholesale and the florist started talking with the grower, and the grower says, yeah, they're really nice and long. And then the wholesale and the florist said, but we only need 70 centimeters or 80 centimeters. And they said, then you can have three layers on one trolley. So transport is much less. We don't need more stem length. And in the end, they got together. The lily grower is cutting them shorter. He is selling more flowers because the lilies got cheaper because of less transport. That kind of communication, I think that's what we're looking for between growers and florists. And also, of course, about colors, about shapes, all those things. We have so much information that we have ourselves, but nobody's asking us. But we need to talk with each other more and more.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah. We also, I already promised Kirsten, you have some beautiful work from weddings. I will show some of those pictures. Maybe you can tell a little bit about what we see here.
This is a floral decoration in island Andros. It's a very beautiful island, and we do summer weddings at this.
Yeah.
If it is possible to show the next photo with a little church in the
let me see
middle of the sea.
I've got so many pictures. This one.
Yes.
Is awesome.
This is a very big garland that drive us to church.
It's
with
beautiful.
Flowers, with astrantia, with greens, Yes.
Yeah.
Very, very beautiful flowers, summer flowers, of course, with different colors. Mm-hmm. We use about 5,000 roses for this wedding.
Wow.
And
oh, wait 1 second. I pushed the wrong button, so I need to get you back in the stream. Sorry for that. Yeah, now you're back again. Sorry.
Okay. Okay.
So many nice pictures. I got too enthusiastic changing them, and then I clicked you. So 5,000 roses, astrantias. I saw passiflora there as well.
Yes, passiflora. Wow. I love open flowers of passiflora. They are like a clock.
Yeah.
I love them.
They are so beautiful to yeah. If you have them, I remember when I was young at our garden, we had the passiflora.
Yes.
And every day you saw new ones popping up and opening up. It's so beautiful.
It's a very interesting shape, the passiflora.
Yeah.
And in Greece, we say that this flower send us the time, the time, okay. The clock of the time.
I mean, this again, what you say, it's already an interesting story. What maybe a flower grower or the grower could use of a passiflora and tell that in Greece they say you can see the time with a passiflora.
No. Passiflora we have in outdoor gardens.
Yeah.
In my home, we have outdoor decorated passiflora.
Okay.
And the summer that flowered, it's very beautiful.
Yeah. It really is.
I like, but it is not a professional production from growers for us. This passiflora I import from my partner from Hamifler in Holland.
Okay, it's really beautiful. Another wedding you did is this one.
Really? Yes, it's a very luxury wedding outdoor at the Athens Riviera near the sea. We have a wedding from a couple from America.
Yeah,
about 200 people invited, and we used about 2,000 white hortensia.
Wow.
And about 3,000 roses, and of course the phalaenopsis white, and more green.
Yeah, wow,
it's a beautiful, and of course patients garden roses at the arrangements of the table. It's a very, very interesting waiting. It's for us one of the best weddings that we have do.
Yeah, I can imagine it. It really looks fantastic, and with the sea in the background. I
mean, yes. We have a lovely sea, the Saronic sea near us, with a very good water, very nice colors, and the people that come from America are very happy for their wedding.
Yeah.
It is the happy part of our work to see. To see the people that came for their wedding to our country are so happy.
Yeah, I can imagine. But how can you not be happy with such beautiful designs? I mean, it's so wonderful.
Yes. It's a very, very, very good wedding.
Yeah, unbelievable. But one question. I mean, there's a lot of sun, and Kirsten is already saying I can feel the sun. How did you do that with hortensia, with hydrangea? How did you do it with hortensia? Because the white...
Oh,
one,
hortensia?
Yeah.
I think if we have a good preparation with chrysal, with water, with conditions of humidity, the hortensia will be strong 2 days.
Okay, that's it.
The next day that I came to collect what remained in tables, the hortensia is very, very fresh and very, very in good condition of okay. quality. It is important to hydrate them very good, to add grisal or something else, and to be fresh.
Yeah,
it is very important.
So it's all about the preparation and of
yes,
course.
Yes. Yeah. If the hortensia is in very good quality, we have no problem. And if we give them humidity, if we give them chrysal, it's okay.
Yeah. I mean, it's all about preparation, and that's also where you
yes.
can show your skills as a florist as well. Again.
Yes. I love hortensia. Yeah. I love hortensia also for summer wedding, for spring wedding. It's very ideal for me.
Yeah, I mean, it's a beautiful flower, and also all the colors. I see more and more colors and shapes and things come out
yes.
in hortensia. It's such a great flower. Here we
the last year we see a lot of colors in the palette of hortensia.
Yeah.
From dark, from light, from big colors, different varieties, and are very, very important for all of us to make arrangement, to decorate every ceremony, to make bouquets. I love to add hortensia in my bouquets.
I
love them.
Yeah, it's such a beautiful flower, but there are so many beautiful flowers, and I can see you doing. You have a big smile when we talk about hortensia, and also about the garden roses, which of course are both beautiful flowers for weddings.
So yes.
So it's really great talking to you, and we're already
Thank
talking
you.
Actually more than an hour. So
we have a lot of other themes. We have to talk about Greek flower industry, about our view. I have no problem about time. If you have time, we organize again for next time.
Yeah, maybe we can call you next time. Maybe when the weddings are back again, and you can show us what's happening.
I promise that I do for you the best.
Yeah, and I mean, you will have a lot of visitors as well. What Alison was already saying, she will pop by, and Kirsten is saying, when this COVID thing ends, I'm off to Greece, and we'll connect with you for some chit-chat. So, and of course, I want to come as well to Greece and get some of the sun and the beauty.
I want to say welcome for all of you, for Kristen, for Alison, for all of people that we are with us now. Greece is a very good country. Greek people are very friendly for all people. And I hope to all this pandemic finish as soon as possible, to come again one close to the other.
Yeah, let's hope
for food, for dance, for food, for dance, for everything.
Yeah, the food is good. My dancing is not so good, so
if we dance at night, no problem.
Yeah, nobody sees.
No one see what happened.
Yeah, Alison is saying Greece can heal the soul, and I totally agree. It's great talking
to you.
Thank
you for your kind words, dear Alison. I hope to see you soon as possible at Poland.
Yeah.
For European competition.
Yeah.
Next, not this year, but next year in Poland.
Yeah, let's hope we all meet already sooner. I mean, that there will be some exhibitions or shows or things like that, because it's already over a year now, and I think everybody is really looking towards the end and finally can meet each other. This is second best. I mean, it's great talking to you, but it's even better to to meet each other in real life.
Okay.
So thank you very much. I really enjoyed all the information you gave us. I mean, this actually, every florist should watch this, and it's not because we are doing this as Flower Circus, but you gave us so much information in an hour time, really good information about what florists should do. And I mean, I'm still a little bit overwhelmed with all the information that you gave me. So thank you very much for that.
Thank you, John. Have a good afternoon. Nice to meet you, and I hope to see and talk again very soon.
Yeah,
thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you very much. Next week, we have a rose grower from Bergroses, Arie van den Berg. So
nice.
Tune in next week at the same time. And the 2nd of April, we will do a show again with Michael van Hamme this time. We will have some Mother's Day inspiration. We have some great flowers already, some growers will send their beautiful flowers. So hopefully you will join then as well. So for now, thank you everybody for watching and listening. I hope you like the show. So if you liked it, please put some thumbs up and stay safe and see you next week. Thank you very much.
Thank you, bye.